Well, officially, they are the supporters of Egypt's football clubs, the football clubs in the Premier League. But although they're not politically affiliated, they're not affiliated to any political party or political group, and they oppose any kind of authority, they're considered to be the unofficial armed branch of the revolutionaries. Now, not all of them, some of them, at least a small group, joined Salafists last December in a protest before the referendum, but they're more often seen in Tahrir Square, around outside the presidential palace when the situation heats up. They move in like a well-organized militia would do, like a military regiment would do, and they go straight to where demonstrators are clashing with police forces.
Now, Alex, obviously victims' families welcomed this verdict, but some, you know, more than 50 people are still awaiting another verdict, amongst them security officials. This case has already sparked a lot of violence. Do you think that the next verdict is going to be politically influenced?
Well, as you said, they welcomed this first verdict. Just 3 days ago, they threatened to take care themselves to execute the defendants in the Portside trial who might come out free, who might be released without a proper conviction. And this shows just how far they're ready to go. The supporters of the Al Ahly Football Club, the main club in the capital, gathered this morning, as you said, to celebrate. And one could imagine that the Muslim Brotherhood, the government, maybe exerted some pressure on the prosecutor, the judges, to get these very harsh convictions in order to reach some sort of a truce with the ultras in the capital for the weeks to come. Now, this might be a short-lived one, considering judges still have to issue their verdict regarding the top police officers who were in charge of supervising the match in Portside. If they're cleared altogether, it might be a game-changer.